Hello everybody and welcome to Gaming with Zombie. Zombie here, and we're playing Minecraft again. So, just doing a little of this, little of that. I don't really remember exactly where I was for that last video. I did a little bit of research and realized that there wasn't a center beam. There was several beams that came from the outside, but there was not actually a... God damn it. There was not actually a center beam. So, because of that, I went and made a couple of changes. Now, I don't remember if those were actually recorded or not, but I did it, so whatever. There it is. So, I don't know who all may have seen, but I did sort of a podcast for Mighty Number 9. Really disappointed. I need to play it a little bit more before I cast my final judgment, so to speak. But for the most part, yeah, I was really upset about it. I kind of thought that this was the route that it was going to end up taking, but I was hoping that I would be wrong, and I wasn't, which is not surprising, but still. You know, it had such lofty goals when they first announced it. You know, they wanted to make the replacement for Mega Man, because Capcom treats Mega Man like garbage. If you are not a Mega Man fan, you can take my word on that one. But for people who are fans of Mega Man, the series in general, you will notice that Capcom has not been exactly friendly towards the series. So, you know, that sucks ass. It would be nice if that was not necessarily the case, but unfortunately, that is how the cookie crumbles sometimes. I know that Keiji Inafune left Capcom, but I can't remember if that was in response to something that Capcom was doing. Like, I want to say that it actually did have something to do with their poor treatment of that franchise, but I don't really remember. He may have just been let go or left for other various reasons and wanted to do something about Mega Man while he was at it. You know, and like I said, high and lofty goal. That's wonderful. But the problem is that you failed to do that. What you made was not at all a Mega Man thing. It had some elements which were okay. The dashing was neat, but the fact that you made it dashing so as to get something from a thing, like, what? Just give me health drops. Why am I trying to dash to do all of this crap? You know, you could have made a Mega Man game with all of those stretch goals that you had without having to change the Mega Man game into something that was not Mega Man. And I know that I think he is expecting not exactly the best reviews, because he has said, you know, I accept any responsibilities for the critiques and criticisms of this game, but I don't think people are wanting you to take responsibility for the negative press. I think people are just wanting you to make the game not bad. You know, there's a difference between, like, we just want to yell at you, and we were putting all of our hopes and dreams for the continuation of a series in your hands, and then this was your review, or this was your response, you know, to take it and turn it into whatever this was. I feel like there were enough similarities that if you had really wanted to do stuff like actual Mega Man stuff, that you could have gotten away with it, honestly. I know that there were some people who were saying, well, he couldn't do a Mega Man game because the Mega Man is so copyrighted, you know, you can't do that. There were enough similarities between these characters, between the Beck character and the Mega Man character that I feel like that's not true. I feel like you readily could have managed to get away with doing a more proper Mega Man game. That's just how I feel about it, you know? I wanted probably more than most people for this to have worked out. You know what I'm saying? Like, I wanted it really badly. Because I'm a humongous fan of the Mega Man series. Mega Man, here's a little backstory about me. So, I'm older. I'm about to be 30. So, shut up all of you young folks. But the reality is that Mega Man was the first video game that I ever rented. Ooh, shit, sorry. There's a microphone there. Yeah, Mega Man was the first game that I ever rented. I remember actually renting that game vividly. I remember the entire experience. Because it ended up being such a memorable thing for me that, of course, I'm going to remember it. You know, it meant that much. So, when it comes to Mega Man, I guess I have a little bit of a history. You know, I've played and beaten every single Mega Man game. That includes the stupid soccer one. You know, and you're not expecting people to necessarily keep the series alive in the way that you're always wanting it to be, but I would have thought that they would do better than what they ended up doing with it, you know? For something that was so iconic, I certainly had expected better treatment, to say the least. But, you know, I guess sometimes it's just not meant to be. I know that for a lot of fans of the Mega Man series, one of the biggest, like, slaps to the face was the Street Fighter game and their handling of Mega Man. And, oh man, it was awful. I'm not sure if you have seen it, but it's not good. It's very bad. It's very bad. Basically, they take Mega Man and they put the cover art version of Mega Man from the original game into the Street Fighter game. So the character is real human Mega Man instead of, like, the Blue Bomber, as it were. Or the character Mega Man from the games. So that is pretty shitty of them. I would not have personally gone down that route. I would have done something, you know, respectful with the character, but you know, it is what it is. It's their character. They can do whatever they want with it. If that means completely destroy the character's memory and turned it into a shit show, well, I suppose that is their right, you know? And I'm sure that somebody thought it was a good idea. Whoever that person was probably could do with a nice drawing and quartering, but, you know, I guess it just is what it is. Now, I know that I've said this before. In fact, I've played that game on this channel before. If you are a Mega Man fan like I am, and you were looking for more Mega Man like game to be coming out of Mighty No. 9, well, I recommend that you go and you try out Megafill X Mega Man Unlimited. Mega Man Unlimited is a fan-made game, and as such, it's not for profit. It's a free game, and because of that, they actually can basically use, you know, the proper sprites and make it into a Mega Man game, which they did. And the characters are all really good. You know, just the way they handled the whole thing in general was really, really nice. And I greatly enjoyed that game, and I know that most Mega Man fans will also enjoy that game. So that is my recommendation to replace Mighty No. 9 on the Mega Man list. Because, you know, you just... Sometimes you want to play some freaking Mega Man, not whatever the hell Mighty No. 9 ended up becoming. So I've played probably a couple of hours of Mighty No. 9, and I need to play more just so that I can have a better hold on it, I guess you could say, for review purposes. But still, I'm so upset about that whole situation. It's just such a downer, you know. This is turned into like the Mighty No. 9 / Mega Man stream, or not stream, but Minecraft session. And you know, it's just one of those things where like, I think everybody wants their iconic characters from their childhood to be treated respectfully, and to get, you know, good coverage media-wise. You know, I don't think anybody's sitting there like, yes, take Pokemon and ruin it. Speaking of ruining Pokemon, let's go ahead and talk about Pokemon Go. When Pokemon Go was announced, I was really, really excited. I had a lot of hope for that game. And from what I've been seeing, I think that is also being mishandled. It looks very much so like they're taking Pokemon Go and turning it into not even a Pokemon game. You know, they basically were touting that you can battle other trainers, raise your Pokemon, you know, battle your friends, go to gyms, and stuff like this. And then, from what I've been seeing, it looks more along the lines of this game is just video game masturbation. It plays itself. You don't really actually do anything. You run into a Pokemon and you push a button. If you even, like, if you have the add-on device, all you do is like push a wrist button. You don't even have to see what it is. It just sort of does it. That is fucking shitty as hell. Where's the Pokemon aspect of that? Where's my battle? And that's one of the things that I've heard, is that there is not any sort of battle system. It just, your Pokemon shows up and flails, and the other Pokemon shows up and flails. There's no, like, ah, yes, I'm flailing against a rock type. You know, the entire premise of the Pokemon battling system was using one type against another, you know, for strength versus a weakness. And from what it sounds like, they've completely removed the entire aspect of that battle. Now, I don't know exactly what your idea of, like, Pokemon games are, but I'll tell you what it isn't. It's not mindless battering back and forth. Now, you may not play as, like, a top-tier trainer. You may not sit there like, ah, yes, I'm going to counter this Pokemon with this Pokemon and use type this, and then I'll use these items to get a boost and blah. You don't have to be like a professional Pokemon trainer. I can say professional, but you know, whatever. You don't have to sit there and be the best Pokemon trainer in the world to play the game. You know, you just have to have basic understanding of, like, I would not send a grass-type Pokemon against a fire-type trainer. You know, that's just not exactly the smartest move. So the concept of just completely removing that whole system in favor of whatever the shit they're doing is terrible. Like, you're not gonna pull your fan base, you know? Because there are still people who are my age who play Pokemon. Hell, I still play Pokemon. So you're not gonna actually get us to be interested. And I guess they're not even wanting us anymore. Like, at this point, Pokemon seems to have been... I guess it was always technically for younger people. It was for kids. But, I mean... You have a thriving base with a ready source of income that doesn't require mommy and daddy. You know, we still buy those games. You're basically just kicking that whole group in the mouth and being like, fuck all of y'all. Y'all are not important enough for us to make this game an actual Pokemon game. Instead, you're gonna get this fucking Final Fantasy XII jerk-off session. Because that's what Final Fantasy XII was as well. It's this concept of, like, dumbing down gameplay so that you don't have to actually play the game anymore. I'm here, right? I'm building this whole stupid Death Star with the click of a mouse buttons, you know? I'm playing Legos with myself, pretty much. And it's a lot of fun. I really love this game. But the thing is, if you just turned it into an automatic, like, here's a picture of this star, boof, make it into square shapes. Cool. Let me just post that right here. Okay, done. Yay. It wouldn't be fun. There's no creativity in that. It's literally just a jack-off session. You know? You're sitting there not even doing anything. The game is playing with itself. And you're basically along for the ride watching and going, yeah. This is awkward. You know? And as such, I just don't understand where gaming companies keep seeing this appeal to these games that are just playing with themselves. I guess there has to be at least some kind of following for these games. Because let's be honest, if the gaming companies put out a game, right? They don't just keep putting out games that don't work. They put out games that sell. So why is Smash Brothers still coming out? Because Smash Brothers always sells. Thank God for that, because I love Smash Brothers. Well, I love Smash Brothers up until this bullshit with the DLC. I'm not a fan of DLC. I think that if you're gonna sell me a game, you either do a big expansion with all of these new things made available, such as, I guess technically Skyrim would be a good example. World of Warcraft, good example. There are still microtransactions, and I'm not a big fan of them in Warcraft, but for the most part, when you buy something in Warcraft, you know, when you buy the game, you can get pretty much whatever it is that exists in that game with enough willpower and can-do attitude, right? As such, you have people who just sort of pay to get this other stuff, and I don't know, man. I fucking hate microtransactions. Even if in terms of Smash Brothers, it isn't quite as bad as some other things, it's still really annoying. Especially if, you know, why don't you put out a version of Smash then that already has all of the characters and everything available, like the updated Smash Brothers? Lower the price on the original Smash. And then you can, because maybe not everybody wants these characters and they don't care, but you should put out the option to not have to do all of the DLC and downloadable content and still be able to play all of the characters. Because I don't get me wrong, I would love to play as Cloud in Smash, That was super exciting to me when they announced it, but I don't want to pay $4 to do that. That's dumb. Like, why in the hell would I want to pay you five or $4, or it's either $4 or $5. I think if you get the 3DS as well as the Wii U characters, it costs a little bit more. But I mean, why would I want to pay that just to play as a character? That does not appeal to me. Another shitty version of that comes into pay to win stuff. For example, like Dead Space 3. Dead Space 3 was basically a phone game. It was like 75% microtransactions and then a little bit of gameplay that people like. But yeah, for the most part, microtransaction city. And I understand that games are pricey, games are expensive to make, so on and so forth, but why the hell would I want to keep. I just don't understand it. It pisses me off like so much that I just can't even deal with it. The state of the video game world is just it's in a rough place. See, you still have good things though, such as Minecraft games, where you have Minecraft and it's supported. They keep doing more of the stuff that you want for the game. And I guess it's just I don't know. I don't understand where we went wrong. This is like the old is this has devolved into like old man zombie talking about the world today and shaking his head. That's exactly what this is. And older gamers might agree with me in this aspect. It's just not the same as it used to be in terms of we made this thing and we're very proud. Like back in the old days, people had passion projects, and I guess some folks still do, but I just feel like a lot of that passion project is sort of fading, and instead we're getting the Call of Duty 58, where it's still, I don't know. And I guess that's not fair because, I mean, if you look at the Mega Man games were all the same game with a couple of tweaks. But, I mean, still. I don't know. This really is just like Old Man Zombie and his video game rant. Whatever. It works. I'm just disgusted at the world, I guess. That's all it is. And I think that that's why. I love how this like inspirational music came on in the background. I think that's why people play video games. You're sick of the world. The world is a terrible place. You're disgusted with the world and the situations in which you have to go through in your daily life. And so instead, we come and we play video games. We create the world around us and we mold it to our desires. Now, that's not always the best thing, but what you end up getting is people with the creativity to build worlds and make places for people to go and have fun and be safe and take a little bit of time away from what ends up being a really difficult world. And you have to respect that fact, Not everybody's gonna necessarily agree with it, but the truth is the fact that we do it It's just as much of a salvation as there being books for people to read or television shows. And over the years, you know, video games have actually really come towards that. You know, now it is definitely an issue of video games are being considered as an art form, and appreciated and celebrated as such. And it's still young, you know, it's still in the infancy stage for all of that. But if you could just look through, you know, a time glass or whatever, go back in time and see where it used to be, you know, I think you would be really surprised at how much it's come along. And as such, I think that there's hope that it will end up being what I want it to be again, you know, and be the passion project and not just about it, about money and all of the downsides that you have to deal with these days. So, you know, maybe that'll end up being a thing and people will be able to appreciate games again. I don't know. Who knows? Certainly not me. That's just my thoughts. So, Anywho, I don't know if I ever actually listed what I was building right here. This is our reactor core for the Big Boomy Laser. So, just finishing it all up. I'm not really sure exactly what I want to end up doing with some of it. I know there's still like a big desire on my part to do a really big version of this and make it nice and detailed, but at the same time, I don't think that there's enough reference material for me to really be able to pull it off very well, so we're not sure yet. Floor accomplished. Oh yes, with a couple of holes in it. Shoot. But yeah, I really should name this episode Old Man Zombie. Yeah. I also need to do a little bit more disassembly of the walls down there. I guess I need to fully assemble so that I can then disassemble a little more believably. I don't know. Who knows? Okay, we're alive. Nah, just fucking with you. I have this really bad habit of, like, I never finish the things that I start. I guess technically this channel is a little bit of a slap in the face to that statement. Because I started it and I still am upkeeping it and I make sure that I take care of it and keep it active and ongoing. So, that's a thing. If you ever have doubts about whether or not you can do something, hey, you know what? You can totally do it. Because if I can do this, then you can do whatever you put your mind to. Being positive. Oh, yes. I don't know. Who knows? Who knows anything about anything anymore? Oh my gosh, stop, you bastard. We're just gonna change it because apparently this side wants to get done. I feel like it would be really amusing at the end of all of this if I just threw a torch on it. I don't know. Maybe. Maybe not. Who knows? I wonder how big that would be. Is like I put the number of hours I've put into this on there and be like 3,000 hours wasted. That'd be popular. Just sit here and sob in the background while it happens. The world's full of sadists, you know? Yeah. Did I ever decide that I wanted to expand this out some more? I think I did. I'm pretty sure I did, actually. Because I clearly have built a lot further out that I has not actually been basically accessed, so. Yeah, that's a thing. Should definitely put more of that down. Because it's so tiny on the front there. I mean, I'm supposed to be having spaceships come through. This is starting to kind of look like a Borg ship, which is funny. It's really weird that you can't really see the, from a certain distance, like you can't see those shapes sticking up anymore. It reminds me of, I was just reading about this thing called Vanta Black, which is basically this color slash, it's not a color, it's actually an actual thing that was invented that is nanotubes, carbon nanotubes, being placed on something, but it's because of the construction of the nanotubes, it basically blocks light from being able to reflect off of the structure. So it is the darkest material in the world, with no reflection whatsoever. It's very nifty. I love stuff like that. I think it's really neat to see, you know, that sort of thing exist. Because I don't know, like, I'm sure it has a purpose, obviously. But I'm not sure exactly what they're wanting to use it for. But I think that it's so neat that it exists in a general sense. The world is an awesome place with a lot of cool stuff. Even if it seems kind of shitty sometimes. Yep. Go away. Can I not? Guess not. There we go. That's big enough. On this side. We'll make it a little bit bigger. On the other side, that'll be wide enough for our bay door, I believe. Really, I should probably count these out. Get an even number. Hmm, 17 so far. This is, you know, this is all just sort of assembled by willy-nillies. I probably could have, like, I don't know, built this in an appropriately numbered fashion, but I don't know, man. I just never really wanted to make it into, like, you know, a really big math feature. Ooh, I can actually get rid of these and trade it out for the lime green. Fuck off with that. There we go. Yeah. Sweet. There we go. That's bigger. I really need to put the diamond down there and get these actually cut on. That way I can know where exactly everything's at. Yeah. One of the neat things about Minecraft, you know, a lot of people I feel like were really concerned, as far as Minecraft goes, when they were basically, why are you not wanting to work now? All of those should be fully functional. Why are you not? What the shit? Why aren't these working? That's the exact same build setup as they are on the other side. So why the shit are they working on right there, but not right over there? What the hell? Do I have something blocking? I do. That's what it is. I hate that. God, that's annoying as shit. I do not understand why the beacon has to be set up to the point that it needs to have absolutely no interference going upwards. That doesn't make a damn lick of sense. Because let's consider the beam for what it is, or the beacon for what it is. The beacon is pretty much just a searchlight, right? It's basically like, behold, here is a source of light. Ooh. So why in the shit is it that it can't be? I don't know. That's dumb. Dumb. I disapprove. All right. So let's put some more diamond down here. Diamond me, baby. Diamond me. There we go. Why are you not working? Oh, because you need another row. Boop. Okay, so now let's count the beams, shall we? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. Here we got 28. Alright with that. I am okie dokie with that. As long as it was an even number, that's all I wanted, was an even number. Cause I like even numbers. Even numbers are making me happy. Actually, that's not true. My favorite number is an odd number. My favorite number is 13. Huzzah, you learned a thing. Welcome, congratulations. Yeah, that seems like a large enough docking bay, don't you think? I'm alright with that. Yeah. I feel like I need to enlarge the beam over there as well. Like, it's pretty big, but it's not that big. It could be bigger. That's what she said. Anywho. So, I think I'm gonna go ahead and call this this episode. Yeah. Old Man Zombie had his rant. E-I-E-I-O. But yeah. I think we had a lot of cool discussions. If you have anything to say regarding those discussions, you should totally leave that in the comments section down below, because I'd be interested to hear what you have to say about it. Maybe you disagree, maybe you agree. You know, open up the dialogue. Let's discuss and see what folks are feeling and thinking about that subject or any of those subjects, because I'm curious to see it. Because just like you guys, I'm a gamer. I play video games. I love my video games. So it concerns me in the same way that it concerns you, because it's one of those things where we all are part of this. So whether things are continuing in a good or bad direction is important. And I'm curious just to see what other people's opinions on the subject are. So make sure you leave me that in the comment section. Leave a like for the video if you've enjoyed this, or if you've had a good time talking about the random stuff that we were talking about. That's about it. Yeah. Check us out on Facebook at GWZombie, or check us out at Facebook, facebook.com/GWZombie. We're also on Twitter at GWZombie. I post when I put up new videos and stuff like that, so you can check all of that out at your own timing and whatnot. Check out some of the videos that I've done that maybe you haven't seen. Yep. Check out some of the other Minecraft videos, that sort of stuff as well. I have, look at you, asshole creeper. Speaking of asshole creepers, I have a very amusing video of me dying playing Minecraft Hardcore, where creepers killed me, and it was a bad time. Hey, buddy. What you doing? You look different from regular zombies. You are strangely colored. Now you're dead. But yeah, so last but not least, after doing the likes and the follows and the clicks and the stuffs, make sure that you check out some of the other videos. And last but not least, I already said that, whatever, click the squishy brains. Squish those brains, won't you? If you squish the brains, then you'll be taken over to the main page. Will you be asked if you would like to subscribe to the channel? Well, the answer is totally yes. So do that and check out some of the other videos. Check out the Mighty No. 9 podcast. It's my first impressions podcast, where I am actually playing the game for the Wii U, which I can't record. So you can see what my thoughts were as they were happening. So, alrighty, we will catch you all in the next one. Bye-o!